Welcome Wolfpack to another SCUM University basic tutorial. This one's going to be geared primarily to the new players. We're going to talk about the inventory screen, the crafting screen, the metabolism screen, the events screen and journal tab, as well as how to lay out your hotbar and use the hotbar in the game. Stick around and we will get right to it. Let's hit our tab button to open up our inventory screen. This is where it will default. You will see what the pants we have and the stuff that we have on the ground. If we found a knife on the ground, we could just take it and drag it, or we could actually double click it and it would be picked up. Activate the crafting menu. We have hit our tab button to get into our inventory. We click over here to crafting. Keep in mind that any material that shows up in red or yellow, you have the ability to craft those items. If they are grayed out, you do not have the knowledge or the high enough skill level to craft those items. So we have a whole bunch of different things that we can craft, from clothing to items to food, blueprints for base building and base building items specifically as well. A lot of things to craft, and there's more things being added every patch. The next thing we're going to go over is the metabolism. You just click over to the metabolism and it will show you all of your things that you will need. All of your attributes here, from your strength skills, boxing, rifles, melee, that you all set up in the character creation window. And if you haven't checked that video out yet, I'm going to put a card up to the top right. I did a whole video on character creation and how I set up my characters. So we have all of our skills here, from conditioning, dexterity, and intelligence. All these things, you'll be able to watch how they level up as you move along and throughout the game. Right here is your sicknesses. This could be anything from hypothermia, which is too cold, hyperthermia, which is too hot, and you have to treat those accordingly. You also have a physical injury, like right now. If you remember, I showed you that the red blood button right there. I have to patch, and I'll show you how to do that in a few minutes. And then you have your BCU performance monitor, and it'll give you all of the things that you need to be watching. On the right side, you have your intake. You need to make sure that your calorie intakes and your usage intake is close. If you take in too many calories, you're going to get fat. If you use too many calories, you're not going to have energy. You want to make sure that most of these things are in the green at all times. Otherwise, your character will start to take a negative buff. In addition, you want to watch your vitamins for the same reasons and your minerals for the same reasons. All of the items in the game affect all of these metrics in a different way, so you don't think you're going to run around and only eat mushrooms and be okay. Your digestion monitor, you want to watch out for the stomach volume. If you eat too much, you're going to throw up. If there's too much stuff in your intestines, you're going to have diarrhea. Hopefully it's not in the middle of a gun battle like I have in this video at the top right. Your colon volume is when you have to poo, and your bladder volume is obviously when you have to pee. Yes, you have to control all of that, and that affects your awareness. The journal tab is the basic tutorial lessons that they have so far. This is also where there are going to be single player missions and things like that in the future. These tutorials will walk you through many of the starting things that I'm going over and get you a basic start on how to play the game. Event screen, this is how you get into the team death matches and things like that. You have all these different areas that you can and will be partaking in. These are all the people on the server with their fame point scores and various statistics. Hey guys, if you learned anything, please smash that like button and subscribe and hit that notifications bell. You'll see on the bottom left there, my health is at 99% because we just got attacked by this Zed and I took a hit. It dropped down a little bit further, but I was able to heal up. You'll see that red flashing blood icon. That means I am injured and I need to patch. My stamina is at 100%. My energy is at 100%. Both of those will reduce as I move around or if I don't eat correctly or what have you. My hydration is at 100% because I've drank enough water to keep myself sustained. Let any of the stamina, the energy, or the hydration drop into the red and you are asking for some trouble. The icon right next to the monitor on the bottom left is the talk command. B is for the in-game chat. So right now, when that's green, people can hear me talking. I'm holding the B button and talking. If people were in the game with me, they would be able to hear me out to a specified distance. It is fainter as they go away from you. It is louder as they come towards you. This is how you communicate with other players if you choose to interact with them. On the bottom of your screen there is the hotbar. Number one and number two are always the items on your back. Those can be anything from a wooden club to a baseball bat, all the way up to the Mark 82 sniper rifle or anything like that. Most of the time, the guns are stored on your back. Some guns will fit into a backpack when we get those, but not typically. The hotbar can be customized to whatever you like. Most items can be thrown in the hotbar, and all you do is drag and drop it over. I had this knife remains in my combat boot, but I can access it by now pushing 3, even though it's in my boot, or quick access for fighting or whatever I'm doing with it. I can also put it away by pushing 3, but be aware when you do this, it goes right back into the first available slot that it will fit. So not necessarily where you took it from, it will go to the first available slot that it will fit. So don't lose items like that. Up on the top right, you'll see the fame points. You'll see that I'm a nobody right now. I have 36 fame points from probably from killing these two Zeds and doing some random stuff, walking around, trying to, basically surviving. And then I'm a rank of a nobody. If you've learned anything from this video, please smash that like button. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. I thank you all for tuning in. I hope this was a quick hit. I know it's very basic for some, but those who are just learning the game, I hope you were able to pull something away from it and learn something to make your gameplay a little bit easier. Thank you for joining us, and welcome to the Wolfpack if you decide to subscribe.